Hello everyone, welcome back to Gaming with Shoggoths. We are continuing on with our playthrough of the Dawn of Ragnarok DLC. I came up here to this bridge. You can hear stuff going on behind me. But I came up here to this bridge because I was grabbing an opal and I found this letter. And keep in mind, I had been facing this direction, so I didn't see anything behind me. But it said, the challenge, I've been following this fire-spewing fool for many winters. At least he has resurfaced in this forsaken, or at last he has resurfaced in this forsaken realm. But why send me this cryptic challenge and a pledge to fight to the death? Has he finally built up the courage, or has he gone totally mad? No matter, I will face him, and I will finish him. And then I realized there was Grunty behind me, and I turned around. So I thought I'd actually record this. I don't know what is going on here, if they're just fighting or what. Or if they're gonna fight me or... Oh, they're just gonna fight me, apparently. They're putting aside their differences so they can both fight me. Lovely. I love the ragdolling that happens in this game sometimes. Alright, well, and this was not like a marked thing either. It wasn't like a... There wasn't a world, like, event thing or anything either, so... I don't know, I guess it was just some silly little thing to see. They look like they were both, like, when I first turned around before I started recording, it looked like they were both, like, drunk and, like, wobbling around, so I don't know. But I'm guessing that just, it means that they've been fighting each other for a long time or something, and then they saw me and they were like, well, screw it, let's kill this one. Or something. Alright, so we are continuing on with our, journey. Issa, yes, we're following Issa, or no, we're not following Issa, we're going to find out what Issa was looking for, because she has escaped our grasp, and yeah, so it is out yonder, so we're gonna hit this, I think, on the way, maybe grab this artifact, and then hippity hop over there into those mountains, which I believe is another cave. Oh, we finally got some light. Like, I feel like it's the first time we've been in the light this whole time. Alright. Whee! It should be mentioned that I have horrible issues with falling. I know, like, who doesn't hate falling, but, like, it definitely, like, even the threat of falling terrifies me, and this game and, like, Assassin's Creed in general has kind of, I certainly haven't gotten over it by any means, but it's definitely helped me get past it, at least in video games, because even in video games, they used to, like, you know, you're, like, your leg would twitch, you get vertigo, you'd be like, oh my god, but, like, Assassin's Creed really just helped me, like, get over that. Or not get over it, but, you know, get past it a little bit. Oops, going the wrong way. All right. Just want to grab this synchronization. Somewhere up here. Probably should have just gone to that hill and run back. Probably be faster. I was trying to use the Raven ability earlier while I was grabbing some opals. And it's really cool if you want to get to the top of a high place, and I'm sure that's what it's for. I noticed on the map that one of those floating things over there has, like, treasure on top. Oh, there we go. That's a better view. One of these floating things has treasure on it, and I'm sure that's how you get there, is with the Raven. But, like, if you're trying to do, like, pinpoint accuracy, not so great, because you can't choose when to end, so you kind of have to, like, keep floating over the spot you want to be at. And you keep going higher and higher, so it's definitely, like, only really helpful for really certain things. Like, I tried to do it up to the bridge, and I couldn't, like, get myself to land on the bridge. It was weird. I don't know if there's just some nuance to it that I'm not quite picking up. Where are we going there? Okay. Once again, still used to Odyssey buttons, apparently. Or not Odyssey. Origins. Man, this realm is so... Oh, it looks so good. I love it. It's so pretty, all the trees and everything. And the gold. That's always nice too, right? Alright. What's over here? Opal, that. Let's just grab that while we are here. Oh, what? And oh, is that a gemstone? I think, right? Uncut gemstone? Yes. Oh god. Durr. I forgot that the ravens attack you. I was just thinking they were gonna fly away. I was totally expecting them to fly away, so yeah. It's good stuff. Alright, well that was easy to grab. I thought that was gonna be more difficult. Oh, we're full up. Okay. Yeah. Let's go, caribou. I did figure out when I was looking at loot and stuff, apparently I'm gonna have to start killing animals again to get some of the loot to upgrade, it would appear. Like I stopped killing them unless they attack me, because I always feel really bad about killing animals in video games unnecessarily. That's just me, yeah, I'm a bit of a softy, what can I say? But, yeah, it looks like I'm... For a second I was like, oh, what's that? That's my mount. That's good. That's great. But yeah, so like, oh, it's up here. But yeah, I think some of these, like, items I'm gonna have to be looting from corpses again, so... Animal slaughter it is. Like, I try not to kill them unless they're attacking me, so... Thick gemstone could be useful. So what's this, then? Chesties. Is there anything else in there? Just that. Oh, it's one little chestie. And some titanium. That's always the important part. And like, I don't grab this stuff either. I mean, I have so much. 57,000 leather, 41,000 ore. And it's not like I'm grinding for it. I just get it from chests and stuff. And I really haven't, like, spent the time to go and, like, upgrade, like, all of my weapons and, you know, like, gear and everything if I don't use it. Because that's just wasted time. I would probably have a lot less if I didn't have that. Let's see. Or if I upgraded all that stuff. Sons of Evaldi message. Beloved comrades, to those of you who seek shelter from the invaders, come join us. You'll find Sanctuary? Wow. You will find sanctuary where the mighty roots force their way into the depths and where the head is lowered but the crown is strong, the Sons of Evaldi. You can put that arrow away anytime now. Apparently not. Is it because it's on fire? Is that why? Okay. Where are we going? these feathers that these guys drop are really hard to come by, so I'm just gonna stop moving. Thank you. Those seem to be the ones that I get the least, probably because they're animals. That stuff from, like, the moose pools and all that kind of stuff is way easier to get, because you're fighting them, like, all the time. So pretty and green everywhere.
Aid me, be my eye.
It's weird that it's telling me it's behind me. Is it under me? What am I looking for exactly? Oh, I think we still need to go that way. Okay. I love the sounds that the caribou makes. Sorry, buddy. Gotta feel bad about killing them. My ravens. Oh, wow, there's books of knowledge? Oh my god, how many more abilities are they giving us? God. Like, I seriously, it's rare now that, like, any of the new skills I find useful. I just, you know, I've put lots of hours into this game. I've completed almost everything as far as, like, little dinky little completionist type things to do. Like, which I rarely have time for these days, so it shows you how much I enjoy the game. And I'm just very accustomed to, like, my preferred, like, skills and stuff like that. And I have a couple that, like, I swap out depending on what I'm doing, but, you know, like I'm old and afraid of change. That's really what it comes down to. So, like, I don't use that stuff very often. I don't know what it is. Maybe it's just because it's the DLC and it's just even more weight, like, and all that, but my computer's not been happy about dropping into water lately. Anything in there? No. What have we got? Oh, they're, like, both behind this door, which I can... Yeah, this is gonna be opened with things. Okay. The sun and the moon...
Tight. That's never stopped me.
No, definitely not. Although, I wish all this, like, incessant talking would stop. Like, I don't need you to, like, tell me every 2 seconds what's going on. To be perfectly honest. I love you, Avi, but... Okay, we really need a thingy.
My spells were here. Still smell that stench in the air. Let's find out what happens if I move these beams.
One door opens when Soul blazes her path across the sky, the other when her pale brother peeks out from the darkness that follows. And Soul's brother would be, Manny. The moon. Oh, these are, okay. I thought these were gonna be arrow target teleporty things for some reason. But, no, they are just these things. Oh, I'm gonna have to, like, move this on here while being magmaed. They really do enjoy making, like, relatively simple tasks, like, complicated. Alright.
This may have to match one of the doors.
But... Can I move? You know I can't. Try this.
Now we're getting somewhere.
Okay, fine. I guess we'll just do it that way. What's up here? Oh. Here is the easy way to get down there, apparently. Could've gone down the stairs. Would like to figure out how to open the other door, though.
Yggdrasil always provides.
Thanks, Yggdrasil. Appreciate it. This is a little God of War shit right here from from 4. Interesting. Okay, well, we'll go in here first and then we'll do that. Let's follow the story for the moment.
Strange place, reeks of death. I wonder what secrets I will uncover here.
Chesty chest. Gold or silver.
More elven symbols. Whatever was in this wall sat undisturbed for many ages. Until now.
Oh, is that a... Was that an apple of Eden? Bet it was.
Whoever was here made it a point to occupy this space. Sigrun and Halstein. Whoever did this, I will see that there is a price to pay. The wounds in their chests. Identical and cauterized. I've seen nothing like it. It's unnatural.
Oh wait, are these the two? Those aren't the two that were showing me around, are they? Oh, that's a bummer. I'm terrible with like remembering names and faces of minor characters, so. But yeah, I mean, those are really the only ones we know by name that were a pair. Yeah, that is, because that's his hair. Oh, that's a bummer. What the hell? God damn, these people, I swear. Is there anything else in here? Oh, yeah. Okay. I have that.
Only moose spells leave ashen footprints like these. One set larger than the rest.
Apparently I looked at these clues backwards. Okay, now what? I freak you out, game, because I did it the wrong way. Yep, drag apparently.
And blood was shed. But only a small amount.
Just,
still alive.
Everyone just, you know, turned it around in your head.
And unlock its secrets. But before she could do so, someone beat her to it. That being led a group of Muspels here. Sigrun and Halstein were likely prisoners among them. Injured, but very much alive. The dwarves were taken to the center of this chamber, where it appears that some sort of ritual was prepared. The orchestrator came for the ancient elven object built into the wall. Possibly even used it in the ritual. Is that what led to the dwarves' deaths? The Muspels then left, taking the object with them. But the purpose of this ritual of theirs remains a mystery to me. That sigil, I think I glimpsed it before in Atri while I searched for Baldur. Perhaps we'll find some answers there.
Alrighty. Okay, I'm not like making it up. I totally heard someone grumbling or something. What? Where is that coming from? I just want to know where this dude is. Alright, we gotta figure out like. Oh! Honestly, I was expecting it to be a dwarf. Like, if Gimli had been standing there, I wouldn't have been that surprised. Yeah, icy rain. Alright, how do we want to do... Oh, wait, you know what I think needs to be... Okay. I think I need to stand in that fire. Alright. Maybe it, like I was thinking it, I could point it there, but the wall is in the way. And I'm fairly certain that these are just normal braziers, but we'll light one on fire and see what happens anyways. Yeah, I don't think that does anything. Okay,
Power at any cost.
Wow, that almost killed me. It even has a picture of the moon right there. What do you want to bet it has something to do with nighttime? Because it's the Manny door. The moon door. I mean, yeah, like, I'm not, it, this certainly wasn't like a genius realization. It should have been an obvious realization, but, yeah. Well, you know. It's kind of neat, though, that they changed. Oh, I probably would have been helpful if I did that first. Okay, Alright, so now we gotta flip these around. Flip this around.
That did something.
Yes, it did do something. Cause we're SMRT. 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 Although it just occurred to me that I have two bars and I could have been using them the whole time. Keep thinking like one's for one and one's for the other, and that's not how it is. Is it or is it not? Hold on, I guess we can look. Let's see. Cosmetic scheme. Is that chip? Oh, it's a tattoo. Oh, but it's, I guess it's not actually a tattoo. That's why they call it a cosmetic scheme. Okay, so, yeah, okay. I'm having one of those days, I think. Oh, okay, there's a tree in here. Oh, I mean, I don't need, okay. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go quickly. Oh, Jesus. I guess we could do that. It's not what I meant to do, just for the record. All right. I'm very smart, and I just remembered I have two bars. For whatever reason, it was like, it was registering in my brain that, oh, that fills up both. I didn't even realize that. It was registering in my brain that, like, one bar was for one side and one bar was for the other side, and yeah, so. Good times. Okay, what was the book? Oh, no, that's not what I meant to do. Oh, explosive retreat. Dream world amplified. Jump backwards and cause lightning to strike the ground, dealing damage in all range. That actually sounds useful. I will give it that. That sounds useful, but I do not want it there. I want it down there. I'm very used to having this skill. I've pretty much had this skill in the circle spot ever since I got it. So it needs to stay there. This needs to go back. I was messing around with some poison things. There we go. Alright. I think everything is as it should be. So there's another level to this somewhere. All right, cool beans. Now where to? Don't know. No marker. Okay. The killer uses a sigil seen in Southeast Eitri. Flags in the correct area will bear the sigil. The area may be heavily guarded. Okay. Southern Eitri. Oh. In here. Okay. Southeast Eitri. So here-ish. Potentially right by that synchronization point. There it may be heavily guarded. Well, I mean, you don't say. All right. Well, let's travel here. I think, yeah, let's go there. Because that'll get us close. And I can also see if there's anything I can upgrade. I don't know if I can upgrade the Hooger Rip yet. And the collector in me wants to go grab all this stuff, but yeah, we'll go here. All right, we're in the dwarf shelter.
I may never wake again. At any point.
Just occurred to me, though, that this guy, yeah, he's still gone. Forgot about that. We just need to exit. Let's see if I can remember where the exit is. Okay, it's not that way. It's this way. Alright. Oops. Barrels and people in the way. Just tripping up the steps. I'm really good at that in real life, so it tracks. I like it when my video games emulate me perfectly. Apparently, this chick is just gonna stand here for all eternity. I can't do my horse here. Make me go up this long winding path. Oh, what is that? That helmet was not there on the compass previously. It's Rodiger. Sinmara's chosen, discovered. Interesting. So They're like the ancient ones, basically. I can only assume. We just gotta go and kill them. Yeah, let's try the new ability. What was it? Oh, the lightning thing. I don't think, did that do a lot of damage? I wasn't even paying attention to the amount of damage it did. I suppose I could do this and not take fire damage. Flat. Bye. Broken blade piece, huh? Let's see what that is. Alright. So, I can only imagine. Are we gonna have an order? No. Those are the children of Danu. So, do we not get a list of those? I guess not. Alright. Just curious what this broken blade piece... There it is. A piece of what looks to be a remarkable weapon, apparently broken into three parts. If I can find them all, a good blacksmith could reforge the weapon for me. Interesting. Alrighty. Is this just loot? Is that what the uncut gemstone is? Wonder. Still carrying around the Auroch, apparently, from Siege of Paris. Like, I would have thought that they would have made it so you could get a trophy out of it, because it's one of the legendary animals, but what do I know? Coffee. It'll be really nice once I get upgraded gear. I can put this on. All right. Okay. So, what kind? Southeast would be like here-ish. So yeah, I think we should probably just go straight for that. Yeah! Let's see if
show me
my dragon bird. What is that? Oh, that's the
I've seen the sigil.
I think that's the skill that I have not yet, like, acquired. I don't see anything else. Although, he thinks...
I've seen the sigil from the vault around here before. Find it, okay. And I may find the culprit. Amid all this excitement, I have had little time to dwell on Ragnarok. When will the storm break? Tomorrow? Or far in the future? I think the latter more likely. I have Loki imprisoned for whatever role he has played in Baldur's predicament. His son, too, is bound by my chains. And what of Sutr? The prophecies say he must play a part in Ragnarok. But for now, he is merely the abductor of my child, not the bringer of the twilight. Still, once Baldur is safe, I will return to Asgard and raise an army. Muspelheim must be conquered without mercy.
All right. So it gave me Birdie over here. Maybe I do need Bird. That's the fast travel, and I've got quite a bit of stuff between me and it. Where was the rope? Oh, that one's too far. I thought there was another rope over here. I guess not. All right. Well, I guess we'll go this way and see what happens. He said he's seen it before, so... here. Roam a little and see what happens. I guess I could have stayed on my mount. See if anything catches our eye. You know what? We should collect this. Just because. That way I have them. Probably should have actually assassinated them, but that's okay. Power of Winter. Weird that a moose bull would have that. This enemy carries the Power of Winter. While it is active, it imbues your weapon with primordial ice, causing your attacks to freeze your enemies. When an enemy is completely frozen, they can be shattered to pieces. Power is especially effective against moose bull giants. Well, yeah, I would think so, yes. Alright, well. Let's give it a whirl. Ooh. Well, that's nifty. Wow, look at that.
Damned flames!
Ah, damned flames indeed. Is there anything in here? No. Okay. Alright. Wonderful. Loot, loot. Over there.
Stretch your wings, Sunan.
What did it say? Flags in the correct area. Ah, flags. Looking for flags. All right. Oh, weren't they over there? Yeah, they're over there. Okay. Okay. Oh, man, you know what? That bird would be really helpful right now. I think I know why the bird's there.
I feel great.
All right. Where's the birdie? Birdie. Oh, God. Oh, there it is. Okay. I like that you can look for that stuff with your raven, dragon, bird friend. Alright, let's really test out this power here. Okay. I think I'm close enough for it to actually trigger what I'm looking for. Come on, get faster. Although I guess we're close enough, but it'd be great if we could get up here. Dang it. See, that's what I'm talking about. Like, it is really hard to, target where you're going. Hopefully, maybe there's an upgrade or something, or... I mean, I looked at the codex, like the tutorial, but nothing there is very specific. So there's nothing that's like, do this to land or anything like that. So I don't know. I guess we'll just have to mess with it. Until I figure it out. I suppose I could have used the other bar to get up here, but it probably would have just led to the same problem. It's just difficult to land. Alright, so... Oh, goodbye frames, Jesus. So, yeah, okay, so there's banners. That's what we're looking for, right? Which one? The circle with the dots. So that right there, I think. Yeah, this one. That looks like it. I guess we'll just run over there like, you know, a person. Ooh. It's gear over here. I know they want me to use the bird. I'm not gonna do it. I'm just gonna climb. Jeez. Wow, they really don't want you to just walk up that. What? Who the hell saw me? You don't see me. I'm behind a tree. That wasn't as effective as I wanted it to be. Okay, my raven picked up a key. He didn't notice. Alright, what the hell's in here? Alright, doesn't really give me any specifics. I didn't see all those guys over there. Good thing they didn't see me. I do appreciate how everyone lives their lives with their backs turned to whatever importance going on.
Shit, is there trouble?
Whoa, that was aggressive.
All
right. Second key fragment. Oh, jeez.
Shit!
That guy just get blown up by his own lava? What? Why am I? Am I on fire? What's going on? Why am I on fire?
Look, you're surely with us. The fire spreads.
I'm not too sure why it let me assassinate when I changed, like, right in front of it. That was an interesting finisher. That lady totally resurrected one of the dead ones. Interesting.
You're mine.
Goddess. I can't believe I'm fighting Samara again already. Like, how many times? This is the third time that I fought her in 4 episodes, I think. I just hate the fact that, like, she runs. I hate that so much.
Taste the flame.
For some reason, I can't get the two-handed sword combo to go off. Or two single-handed sword thing, whatever. God, chaos. Can't see what I'm doing. And then she disappears. Like always. Stand still. Oh, seriously? Fine, you know what? I'll get the gear in a minute. Million keys.
The ritual at the vault. This one's here.
For a second, I thought the window was two arrows pointing somewhere.
The culprit was deciphering elven runes. Something about the binding of only the most powerful hoogers.
Binding of the most powerful hoogers.
Writings on the ritual. They are performed at night. There's emphasis on something called a salakar. My elven is rusty. Vessel of souls, I think. Is this the object from the vault?
See, like before, he was like, what does this thing mural on the wall say? I can't read it. And now he's all like, my elvish is rusty, as if he knew it, but he just was too lazy to even try. Of course, I wouldn't put it past Odin to be like, hey, there's someone here that I can make do this for me. Well, I guess that would fall into being lazy now, wouldn't it? All these little looty corners.
A letter from Sinmara. much secrecy about the culprit's affairs. Only she and Sutra I wear.
It almost seems like Sutra is working against his own daughter. Which is probably what she means by, like, you know, you don't know my father, if he thinks that he can trade her for Balder. Oh, apparently there's more clues. What did I miss?
The culprit searches for a Jotun and a Muspel subject to complete their work.
Huh.
Muspels killing Muspels.
Well, I mean, people kill other people of their kind all the time. Not too sure why that's particularly surprising. There's still more. There's still more. What the heck? I don't see anything else. Game, are you being weird or glitchy? Or am I just being blind and dumb? Got that. Got that. We got those. That. I mean, what else is there? Oh. I'm being blind and dumb. Found it.
The vault is marked here, along with a second location. Another ritual site, perhaps.
You're light on your feet, Aesir. Following me now?
You've become quite useful, Aesir. My gratitude for opening the vault. Now tell me, what happened there?
I'm following the stink as it rises. As are you. Care to tell me why that is?
Days ago, Sinmara ordered my best warriors to the vault without bothering to inform me. I've not heard from them since.
Well, you're casting your suspicions at the right people. Whose quarters are these?
His name is Calder, an adept in magic. Or Seder, as you Asgardians sometimes call it. This place is where he practices it.
Whatever he's doing, it is not Seder. At least not as I know it. He is using something called a Salakar. It is part of a deadly ritual. And from what this room tells me, the dead will continue to pile up. Dwarves. Jotnar. Muspels.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You wouldn't. Your stepmother despises and distrusts you. Your father only the latter of those, for now. But in time, thanks to her venomous whispers, he may come to hate you as much as she does.
This is a lie. All of it. Your twisted attempt to pit me against them.
Sift through the mesh yourself. No other truth lies within.
Where are you going?
After the Salakar. Whatever it is, your father needs it. It may be the only leverage I have to get my son back. Calder marked the place on the map surrounded by waters just northeast. If he's planning another ritual there, I may be able to understand what value this Salakar holds.
We're just bouncing around everywhere, apparently. Narrow escape. Discover. Cover something. Oh, it's the same thing. Okay. Alright, well, I guess we'll just continue on with this because I could just see this being like a few minutes and then the end and I'll have started a new episode and blah, blah, blah. Well, this dwarven place is becoming very handy. Following me. Oh, Raven. Come here, birdie. Bird's got skills. Oops. Really? feathers. Really need to go and like a lynx, huh? Oh, don't you dare. It looks like you're sneaking up on my mount.
Oh. You.
Of course it's a Jotun. Of course. So weird, like the kick-ass combo, like I cannot get it to go off anymore. Strange. All right, up here? Yes. I do love how I can hanging on to smooth edges. There must be tiny, imperceptible patches of roughness that I can cling on to. What? I mean, I love that dive, but that was not helpful. Thanks, game. Appreciate it. I'm glad we had this interaction. So pretty. Where are we going? That way.
Cast about this land, my friend.
Right there. Okay. All right, yeah, probably could get back on my mount. Water looks so pretty. It's like iridescent. Deer. All right.
Calder may be nearby. This roof should give me a clear view.
This roof. Which roof? I guess he means this roof, this really tall roof, but... This one with an easily accessible roof. Oh, like literally right there, okay. I mean, why there though? Why not... Where I was, it's taller, better view.
Lord Calder, with your permission, we will now return to Asa.
Soon, I have need for you still.
Asa's warriors, where do they fit into all this?
You are one of our captains, yes?
A duty I share with two others here.
I thought I saw something in you. Stout, resolute. Step over here.
Uh-oh, no, don't do it.
And Holstein were two of the most revered sons of Ivaldi. If such prestige is a requirement for these rituals, then Calder is surely luring that Muspel to his death. I wonder if there's a way I can observe the ritual up close. I need to approach Calder without him taking notice. Perhaps the best way is with deception.
Yeah, thanks. I've got that figured out now. Thank you. Oh, maybe I should just do it right here before I fall into the... Down, down, down. No. Oh, my God. Are you kidding me? Well, at least it'll stay during the cutscene. Look at that. Stab him! Oops. Is that what we wanted to have happen? What was that? Oh, well, I mean, I know what that was, but... I think that was Baldur covered in mistletoe.
No! Mind the Salakar!
Let me kill him!
Kill them!
Calder fled northwest, with Asa snapping at his heels. He can't have made it far.
Why did it target a dead body? Ouch! Flames hot! I was just, like, standing there in that fire. I mean, at this point, I catch on fire so much from the lava, it doesn't even really matter. God, how many? What the heck? I'm, like, stuck in, like, a damage spot. How many freaking guys are here? Escape the area. I mean, okay. But I wanna, yeah, hold on. I wanna get the loot first. Walked right in it. Oh. Alright. Oh. Such a, like, a common puzzle now. I didn't even think Dwarven blacksmith cloak. Ooh, it's red. I like red gear. Like, it's such an automatic thing now when I see one of those little stone things. I'm just like, yes, I must move it to a ladder to climb up, and we're good. Like, I didn't even think about it. I was just like, there's a ladder here somewhere. No, not that. That. There we go. What else do we got in here? Is it in here? No. Man, even the slightest touch and it lights me on fire. That. Sonmara's letter to Calder. My most darling Calder. Oh. Is that... Wait. I thought Sonmara was... Suitor's... lady. Okay, apparently either I'm misremembering that or she's like she's got like a side guy. My most darling Calder. Wait, maybe it's her son? I don't know. To further our discussion, we must accept the possibility that the enemy will stumble upon the evidence sooner or later. After all, he's not without his talents. Thanks. In which case, we must view this as an opportunity to heighten his sorrow to unbearable limits. Let's arrange the evidence in some heartwarming pose. It should be done in such a manner that when the enemy discovers it, he believes, albeit briefly, that he has indeed saved the day. Thus, when the reality hits him, his anguish will be all the more delightful. Oh, you bitch. And I mean that in a non-gender specific way. Ugh. Trying to trick me. Okay. There's an opal up here. Opal. Oh, no. It's not up there. It's in here up there. Weird spot for it to be. Wow. Yeah, that is a really odd spot. I don't know how you would ever have seen that without knowing it's there. But, whatevs. Alright. Alright. One last chesty chest. Fantastic. Alright. And now we can escape, and I don't think it matters which direction in which we escape. Oh, seriously? I mean, that's funny, but come on. Like, I feel like with this whole... fire thing now, like my parkour jumping for short distances has suffered greatly.
He's chased after Calder like a rabid hound. Though he is no helpless rabbit. What signs might I find of this pursuit?
Oh god, so many skill points. Just handing them out. Alright, that is definitely going to wrap things up for this episode. It's going to be kind of a longer one. I'm looking at a recording time of an hour and 30 minutes, though I imagine I can cut that down a bit because there was some just random screwing around. But anyways, yes, as always, appreciate you checking out this video. I hope you're enjoying it. So far, the story is interesting. Not entirely sure what's going on, but, you know, we're getting into it. And I'm sure we'll figure it out eventually. Again, this is a long DLC, so, you know, being a few hours in and we still don't really know what's going on is not that surprising. It is about the length of a standard video game in itself. So, we'll see what happens. But yeah, thanks for joining me on this journey through the dawn of Ragnarok, and I'll be back with more real soon. Until then, have a good one.